Hello dear students, welcome back to our English class again. Do you remember the previous class what we learned about the merchant's son? Do you remember students? Yes, what happened in the previous class? A merchant's son bought a new book which cost very high and the book contained only one verse, that is, you get what is destined for you. And the father got angry and he sent the son out from the house. And he reached a village and there many people met him and they asked his name. He said the same answer, you get what is destined for you, right? And here the princess fall in love with a prince, a handsome prince. And by mistaken, the prince's servant given a note to whom? To the merchant's son. And he entered into the prince's house or castle. And there the princess identified him. And she scolded and shouted at him. And he went outside of the castle, right? Then what happened? Again, he went into a temple. There the watchman of the temple called him to his home to sleep. And the same mistake he done here also. What happened? He, with mistaken, he entered into her daughter's room. There, his daughter, this watchman's daughter is waiting for her would-be. Would-be, right? So, what she done? There, the light was off at that time in the room. And she thought that this man was his, her would-be. And she put garland against him. And according to the Hindu customs, it was the symbol for marry. Right? This is happened. Okay? Come, let's see what happened. The young man said, you get what is destined for you. When she heard this, she realized she had done a mistake and thought, such mistake is bound to happen when you would rush into doing something without thinking sufficiently about it. She cursed him and threw him out of the house. So, what happened here? She put the garland against him. And she married this man, right? Now, what happened? The young man said, you get what is destined for you. Hearing this, she realized that this man was not her would-be. And she was very angry. She shouted at him. And what she done? Yes, if you do a mistake without thinking. Here what happened? She didn't think. Right? She thought that in the darkness, this man was her would-be. And without thinking, the second time she done this. She put the garland against him and she shouted him and she cursed. Cursed means used to express irritation. Cursed means used to express irritation. Okay. So, she was very angry and she shouted against him. He showed irritation against him and she told him to get away from the house. Okay. Suddenly, by being treated in such a manner, without being at fault, he was walking slowly when he saw a marriage procession approaching. So, he was very sad now also. Suddenly, he came outside the home and she was walking. On the way, he saw a marriage, procession. Procession means a number of people moving forward in an ordered fashion in a ceremony. Procession means a number of people moving forward in an ordered fashion in a ceremony. Okay. So, we know that during the marriage ceremony, all the people will dress well, they use the ornaments and they will walk through the streets, right, in some places. So, here this also happened. He found this marriage procession and he also joined with this group. Okay. They wore magnificent clothes and precious jewels. So these people, they wore magnificent clothes, very good looking cloth, and there were many jewels. Okay, he followed the groom's procession, which was going to the bride's home, where a lavish ceremony was arranged. So here, this bride, they were going to the bride's home. Okay, so this man also followed this group. Okay, all of a sudden, a mad elephant rushed towards the procession, and everybody ran helter skelter. So suddenly, what happened? Suddenly, a mad elephant rushed there, and what happened? All the procession. The procession means what? This group. Okay. So this group, all what happened? All get confusion, and they ran. What? Helter and skelter. Helter and skelter means here and there. All are running here and there. A mad elephant enter into the group, and what will happen? All were afraid, and they run helter and skelter means they run here and there. Okay, the bride stood there in the middle of the turmoil, too afraid to run. Okay, so the bride stood there in the middle. She don't know what to do. And what happened now? Okay, she stood there and she was confused. Turmoil means she was confused and she don't know what to do. So she stood there in a place. Okay, seeing this, he got hold of a huge nail and jabbed it into the elephant. So seeing this, this handsome merchant's son, he took a sharp needle, okay, and poked with something sharp. Okay, poked with something sharp. Okay, seeing this, he saw that the bride girl was standing there and she don't know what to do. So this man took a sharp needle and poked against the elephant. Okay, the elephant got frightened and ran away. So the elephant got frightened and it ran away from there. Okay, after a while, when the bride's friends and relatives returned, she said, "At the moment when my life was in danger, there was none to help me except for this courageous stranger." So after the elephant went away, the friends and relatives came near to this girl. Then she said, "Now, just a minute. Now, what happened? No one is there to help me. Only this man, a stranger, a courageous man, helped me, and he saved my life. I will marry none other than him." So she told, "I decided to marry this man. I won't marry any other person. This is my firm resolution." Resolution means a firm decision. Resolution, a firm decision. Okay, so this is a firm resolution, means a firm decision. I won't change this from this. This is a firm resolution, a decision. I want to marry this man. Why? Because he was a courageous man. Even if he was a stranger, he helped me from that mad elephant. So I decided to marry this man. Okay, the groom's friends and relatives were offended by these words, and there was a heated arguments. So the people, the friends and the relatives, they argued. They told what they said. "Oh, a stranger, you don't know who he was, and how will you marry this man?" Their relatives and friends argued, and there was a heated arguments, a heavy arguments held here. Okay, now turn the next page. When the words reached around, the king had to come himself to pacify everybody and stop the argument. So this news spread all around and this news reached against the king and the king want to solve this problem. So he also came to this place. Everyone including the princess and the watchman's daughter came to that place. So I told you that everyone there in that country reached this news and everyone gathered there. Among them the princess, you remember that princess? Yes, the merchant's son entered into the palace. So there that princess arrived here and the watchman's daughter, you remember that lady? So she also arrived here. Okay, the king asked the young man, you were present in the ceremony. It is being said that you served the would-be bride and everybody from that mad elephant. So the king asked to this young man, oh young man, are you here in this when the incident happened? Are you the one who saved this bride? The king asked. Okay, I asked you to clarify the whole thing to me. So now you have to tell what happened here. Please clarify the thing, the king asked. All the young man said was, you get what is destined for you. So here the same answer. What is the same answer? You get what is destined for you. Okay. The princess and the watchman's daughter were embarrassed to hear the words. Now, embarrassed. See? Ashamed. Embarrassed, ashamed. Okay. So the princess and the watchman's daughter was embarrassed. They feel very ashamed to hear this. Okay. When the king heard this and saw the princess and the watchman's daughter blushing, he demanded to know the truth. So this watchman's daughter and the princess were discussing about this. Okay. Now the king heard this and the king asked to these two to discuss what happened, and he told them to explain what happened. Now see, next page. The night watchman's daughter confessed of marrying him by mistake and said, it was my destiny and I do not repent it. So the night watchman's daughter, started first. What is she said to the king? Oh king, it was my mistake. In the darkness, without identifying, I done that mistake. What is the mistake she done? She put garland against this man. So I am not, I don't feel anything for that. And it is my mistake, she told. Now the princess. The princess explained to the king that she had entertained him with food and drinks by mistake and said, it was my destiny and I do not regret it. So the princess said, oh, it was my mistake and without, in the darkness, I too didn't notify or notice who this man was. And I thought that it was prince and I treated him with food and I given comfort. And this, it is my mistake. So, it is my destiny, means it is my mistake, she told. On hearing them, the bride approached the king and said, O king, what destiny has already been given to me? None can take away from me. Now, hearing this, the bride approached means come closer. Approached means came near. Okay, hearing this, the bride came nearer to the king and said, what she said? O king, what destiny has already been given to me? None can take away from me. So, what destiny? What is allotted to me? What destiny is there? None, nobody can change me. This is my firm decision. I can't change. Okay? After hearing everybody and consulting with his ministers, the king arranged for a ceremony. Consulting. See? Taking expert advice. taking expert advice, okay, consulting. So after consulting his ministers, what is the decision that the king taken here? See, the king arranged for a ceremony, means a grand function, okay. The king arranged for a ceremony. He gifted the merchant's young son 1,000 villages. What gift is she, he gifted? 1,000 villages, okay, apart from the gold ornaments, and also gold ornaments. He arranged the marriage of the young man with his young princess, and also he arranged a marriage of the young man with the princess, his princess, okay, and made him his heir to the throne. And he, students, do you understand the lesson? What is the thing that we learned in this lesson, students? It is a story, but what you learned? You get what is destined for you. Means what? You cannot change your future, right? Can we change our future? No, we can't change our future. Okay? It depends upon the destiny, okay? That is, we understand from this lesson. Okay, students, have a nice day.